It's Mike Ross, also known as Mike on the Mic. He's getting ready for his upcoming 2022 comedy run. He'll be kicking it off at Benny Brand's Stress Factory Comedy Club, Caroline's on Broadway, Punchline Philly. You don't want to miss him take the stage at the DC Improv. Then he'll be coming to the Atlanta Improv and at Chocolate Sunday's Comedy Show in Los Angeles, California.
What up, everybody? It's the Chakra Doctor. Put your money where your mouth is. June 11, 2022, Houston, Texas. All-day healing event from 3 p.m. to 10 p.m. Private sessions, group sessions. Positive food, positive music, positive people. The link is in the description of this video, and you can call the number in the flyer for more information.
A little bit. He put a post up, right? And he said that pretty much that straight N-words, you need to show more love to my gay N-words. I don't know if you've seen that. If I can play the video if you want to hear it.
Nah, I don't even have to hear it. I don't even have to hear the content. No, I didn't see it. I don't spend a lot of time basing things what's going on with these other cats and social, because everybody jump these weird fences when they choose to. What is the demand? What are you telling people that they have to do?
Right.
Is this a demand?
How do you make it seem?
It's like you have to start doing this. Why?
Right.
Why do I'm just saying why? I think people got to understand this. If you want the most resistance ever in the world to happen, force people to have to accept something. Mm-hmm. Force them to have to do it. If that's your thing, that you're going to bully people or ostracize people into supporting anything, try to make me do something. Try to make me do something. Anything, just try to do it. Just force me into the position. Were you making me do something? Then you have a really, hey man, I was over here chilling. You came and told me I had to move over here.
Right.
And I asked you why. And you said, because I said so. And watch me double down in my seat. Now that I'm not moving, what's gonna happen? Because you made this contingent as soon as you said that I had to, instead of having a conversation with me and getting my perspective and giving your perspective and then leaving with respected perspectives, even if we don't agree. I'm not agreeing to disagree. I'm living with the understanding of why you agree and you know why I disagree. And that is it. I don't have to respect it. I just know what it is. This is where you are, and this is why I'm at. And we had the dialogue. We came to some points that may have been conducive. Then we came to some points that's not. People say that same shit towards Black people. Black people, we have to stop killing each other. And we have to, it's mandatory that we stand together in financial power and strength and family and economics and build a community that's dominated like we go and spend our dollars in other people's community. Black people, that's what you got to do. But you don't never hear them say shit like that.
Not once.
You try to conform to whatever you think is gonna get more dollars in your pocket. And that's because people man, this I just need the support so I can get financial currency from the support. That shit there, man. Whatever Ray J's plight was with that, okay.
Right.
I don't. And then, in turn, let's go to something deeper. So you gonna tell me to do something in a derogatory manner? You gonna call me a nigga at the end of it?
Man.
It's crazy.
Let's be clear. I use it and it's derogatory. Mm-hmm. Regardless, I'm not above saying when I'm wrong with it, man. I say nigga all the time. Dick Gregory said all the time. I'm saying nigga said all the time. But if I'm trying to address you in a manner, I'm not gonna come to you like that. I'm gonna come to you the same way that I go to the bank and I'm asking for a loan.
Mm.
Hey, how you doing, sir? and the reason why that I think that this is a good investment, this is a, like, man, I'm gonna talk to you in a manner that's gonna be non-confrontational, that's gonna be soothing. That's how things gonna happen. I just think that people should stop trying to force people's hand in things, man. It's like trying to get me to be with a woman who has a lot, I'm not talking about, because I want to be clear on this, because, you know, I know people get upset. well, I had a baby and I had to ask her. We're not talking about you, man. Y'all know who we're talking about. We're talking about somebody who went to Mexico and got all sorts of shit done to them, you know what I'm saying, in searching for whatever that they're searching for in that, whether it's enhancement, whatever. I don't like no enhanced people. Like, for me, like, I'm not gonna get a woman who got a fake ass. I'm not gonna get a woman who got fake titties. This shit, I'm not gonna get fake lips and eyebrows and wigs and shit unless that happened and that's a medical condition. I'm not searching out for somebody who don't, it's just not me. I don't even like nails. I don't like long ass fake nails. If I see you with long nails, bacteria infection comes across my mind immediately.
Damn.
Like, how can you clean yourself properly with all of that shit? Like, it just, that's just how I think. Hmm. That's my preference.
Mm-hmm.
I don't get mad at you when you say I'm not your cup of tea, because I'm 5'7". I'm big eyed. I got big ass teeth. I'm small and fat. It's crazy. You know what I'm saying? It's weird. It's like, sometimes, you know, sometimes I'm lean, and other times you catch me from the side, you're like, this little nigga got a gut. You know what I'm saying? But I'm you know, I am what I am.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not a materialistic cat, so I don't wear jewelry and shit like that. That's not me. And I don't think every dude that wears jury is materialistic. I'm saying that's not me. I don't get mad at you for your what you say that you like, so you can't get upset with me what I'm okay with.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Facts. Absolutely.
I'm not gonna choose that for me.
Right.
But do I say, oh, you shouldn't? I'm not rallying against you doing it either. Hey, man, do what the fuck you want to do. That's just not for me. Is that not cool no more? Some shit not being for you? Hey, man, guess what's not for me? I don't like a bunch of fake ass niggas around me. Not for me.
Yes, sir.
I got one fake nigga. That's the only nigga I can deal with. I got one. And you everybody got that one fake nigga. You like this nigga here, man. Yeah. But you've been knowing a nigga too long to get rid of him. You like, hey man, if this, hey man, don't tell this nigga right here nothing. And everybody in the crew know that nigga's the last nigga to find out. And you know he ain't even coming. Hey, yo, I'm gonna be there. You like, hey man, this nigga Brian is not coming. This is fake ass nigga. Hey man, everybody buy their ticket to Miami. Fuck Brian. He ain't coming. And he gonna call with some bullshit. Hey, you know my baby got sick. Nigga, this. The baby's not born yet. How the baby gonna be sick? It's not born. You're like, hey man, you know, they were saying, get your ass off my phone.